taken in Venice, this was, at the back of the Fenice Theatre. Here, you see, the idea was that I didn't like that line across there. It's far too wide, and all this was a bit sort of grotty. This man was here, was standing there, just looking in the water for a long time. And I thought to myself, well, sooner or later, some girl's going to walk across there. And obviously, being an Italian, he's going to look at her. So that's what happened, exactly as predicted. That was the gentleman in question. Here you can see the whole of the foreground has been darkened down, all this area here. All this has been lightened here. That's been taken out completely, you see, here to show that all that's dark. And this area here has been brought round to bring the line round here up to here, you see. And that's the final result. All the highlights was picked out, of course, with the rubber. I mean, some of these ideas some people like and some people don't, but it gives you an idea of this type of bromoil that I like, because they are essentially what I call heavy bromoils. They're not the light, beautiful things that some people turn out. John Sandobin used to, he was a member of the London Salon, he used to turn out those beautiful small bromoils, but they were very, very delicate, and they were never more than about whole plate size. He also worked an awful lot in transfer. Now this one's got a history to it, because I took this out of a bus between Florence and Siena, and I just stuck my camera up against the window and blazed away out the window. Unfortunately, of course, I got the reflection of the window in as well, as you can see in the original print. But that's the original print of it. But the bit that struck me of interest was the little house in the background. So what I did was to do that with it. And you see, that's just the centre of the, what's the name? It was a very thin negative. Something went wrong. I got the exposure wrong, having shooting through the window of the bus. And I had to intensify it about the negative about four or five times in chromium, and that brought the grain up a bit. But this, of course, was ideal for picking out the highlights, wasn't it? Now this one, Mostar. Poor old Mostar, it's been bashed around by the Serbs and all the rest. Everybody's had a go at it, I gather. This is the bridge, Mostar. Anybody who's been to Dubrovnik will know this bridge. Everybody goes there to see it, and it's a marvellous bridge. But when I went there, I've been there twice, actually, it was quite obvious that the background was not really suitable, and neither was this large expanse of foliage in the foreground. So what I did was I was standing on the bridge up the river, and then I looked round, and in the distance was a lovely old monastery. It was a lovely old monastery. It's been bashed to bits now, I understand. But I took a shot of it, and then proceeded to put that shot on the bridge shot. And if you look at that carefully, you'll see the resemblance between that and that, because that window is that window there. And then the monastery was put in, of course, and that covered up that nasty corner there. And that was the bottom of the original, which is there. But the top half is being put in. It's an ideal subject for Bromoil, of course, because all these highlights were picked out. All this was picked out and all that thing. And altogether, I had a great deal of fun with that. That was the print from which I copied it. A flat print, of course, which is what I wanted, quite apart from the fact that the paper was about 25 years old, but that didn't matter. And all this was brought out on the final print with the old magic rubber. And there we are, that was that one. Another, what I consider a good example of making a composite picture is this one here. The cottage, but I was in the Camargue and I saw this cottage, which I thought was a beautiful cottage. But it didn't seem to gel somehow or other. It doesn't hang together, you know, it sort of bits and pieces. I thought, well, a little while later, I was I think it was in Ronchiglione again, that's right. And I decided that that little cottage with that foreground was rather nice. There were also some trees and things here which had to come out. But so by photographing that and reducing it to the size of that, you could put it into a shot, and you got that nice winding road. And here was the second cottage, of course, you see, which was there. Again, a put-in sky, not a very effective one, I'm afraid. And again, the old magic mountain, which appears in so many of my prints, I'm afraid. That's that one. When you put the two together, of course, you copy it vertically so that you don't get any shadows. That's the best thing to do. Then, when you do your bromo with a very careful retouching knife, you just go around the edge, and any bits that show up obviously, you just scrape away, because you've got to remember that when you've done your bromoil, again, which I'll explain in a minute, you've got a print which is ink on paper. If you cut the ink away, you're left with white paper underneath. So you can then carefully retouch the thing, and retouch a bromoil sometimes takes you 2 or 3 hours. In fact, sometimes it's a lot more than that. But to me, that's the fun of the thing. And the fact that it's a fiddle, I don't care less, you know. And this one I was very pleased with. Again, taken on a very foggy day. And that was the original bromoil. Now, when I looked at that, I took one look at that and said, oh, Lord, that's no good. So that had to come out. And all these highlights had to come out. You had a nice stormy sky. So that is the final print, where you see you've taken out the, it's quite simple, or just lay a piece of paper on the bromide when you print it, you see. Little tongues like that you can put in quite easy, you don't have any problems at all. And this was all picked out with the rubber to bring the highlights here. Again, the old magic mountain in the background. I was rather pleased with that one. Do occasionally do prints I like. But it just shows you what you can do. You can take bits out, you can put them in, and of course the trouble is at the local club, and the moment anything comes like, oh, he put it in, you see, well, of course it didn't put it in. This one was fun. Taken in Dubrovnik. But look at that. There's a dirty great lump of rock there, which is no good. And the steps sort of go out of the picture. So what I thought to myself, well, if I do another print, of that those steps there, I can put them across here. I could then photograph a bit of that wall and stick it there, as far as that, and I could photograph those steps and bring it down to there. Now, you won't be able to see this very well, but that's the result, you see. I think it lacks a figure, and I waited for a long, long time for somebody, old peasant or somebody walking up here with a shopping bag, and I've got the negative now, but I've still got to do that print. This is the bromoil I did off it, but there's something missing, you see. Here's the steps going up there. That's where that large lump of rock was, which was this bit here, that bit, and these steps were brought across from there to there, you see. But still there's something missing. That's what you want. You want the figure there. And as I say, I've got the old girl carrying a great heavy load up there. And luckily, she was walking away from me, which was absolutely ideal. I couldn't have done it better. This was also taken in the Barcelona Fair. Now, this represents a street in Cordoba. Now, when I looked at that, the obvious thing to do was to light that lamp, wouldn't it? If you light the lamp, you get a pool of light down here, and all this is shadow. And referring to what I said about the colour of inks and things, this is the final result, which was a blue ink and a bit of black ink mixed in with it. Now, again, bearing in mind, rubbed out what what was the ink underneath, and you've got you've lit the lamp, haven't you? Which is what you want. And this is just a question of shading it in with the brush, inking all this bit, inking all that bit, keeping that lock reasonably clear, and making sure that was quite white. That's the original. Now this one, because this, quite frankly, is my favourite. I went to a place called Bonagil, which is near south of the Dordogne, a place called Fumel. And it was a magnificent castle. But when I looked at it, I said, oh my God, I wish that was against the skyline, because I didn't like all these trees here and I didn't like all that. So the next thing to do was to get hold of the negative. Luckily, it was a 2¼ square, it was a 3645 negative. Painted the negative very carefully under a magnifying glass, and you can just see the remains of the trees there. Took all that out, and that was that, you see. The next thing, of course, was to print it the other way, which is that, because you didn't want all this rubbish down here. So having done that, it was a question of going around, we live at the foot of the Downs, a question of going around and finding, first of all, doing a reasonable print of it, and then finding somewhere where I could see a decent sky. So I waited till there was a very stormy day, went up on the Downs, took a photograph of it, and that's the sky I selected. But since I always like to draw my own skies in, clouds have a habit of going in the wrong places, I then did a print of it like that, which was really this one here, and then proceeded to ink it in. I waited about 2.5 hours for that shot. I sat on my backside on the hill opposite with a friend of mine, and I said, well, Lord, it's never going to clear up. And it didn't. So we had to make a bit of artificial sunlight. So all these sides of the towers and things were rubbed out to give them the round effect. This one here, and all down here, you see, all here, all here. That was cut reasonably dark, so I didn't want them to... that little bit was darkened. And this little... Well, I don't know what it was. It looked like a mill of some kind down there. That was lightened up. And referring to what I said about inking with a wet brush, the final of that print was inked with a wet brush all over, and that's why you've got that huge, great contrast on it. It did rather well, actually, so I think somebody must have liked it. But as you see, going back in progression, we've got... It started from... it started from that, which was taken from the other side of the valley. The background, that was taken out. Print was made of that. See how it was going to look. And then the sky was up on the Downs, South Downs, at the back of our house. Made a print of that. So if you want to economise on paper, don't take up Bromoil, because you can get an awful lot of fun out of it. But it's not a quick process, of course. It's a very interesting process. But then I love it. I think it's a great process.